restrictive pronunciation and fear-mongering had created a climate of fear and suspicion across the country, raising the question in households across the nation, who are the un-American Americans amongst us?
May I take your coat?
All right, I suppose.
Oh, not to worry, Colonel. It's just the maid in the hall. The champagne cork.
Champagne!
My pleasure, my dear.
This way, monsieur.
Thank you. Are you expecting someone else?
Indeed. I'll be with you in a moment.
Follow me, Colonel.
Don't mind if I do.
Do come in, madam. You are expected. Welcome.
Do you know who I am?
Only that you are a socialite, to be known this evening as Mrs. White.
Yes, it said so in my letter. But why?
May I introduce you, Mrs. White? This is the maid, Yvette. I see you two know each other.
We've never met.
Champagne? I think not.
Please, warm yourself loud.
Why? Do I look cold to you?
A bit.
Oh, the mold in here is gorgeous. Oh, wow. Oh! Oh! Hello.
Hello. Pleased to meet you.
I'm rarely pleased to meet anyone.
Oh, yes. Mrs. Peacock, I presume.
Who? Oh, yes, that's me.
Cook, will you please take Mrs. Peacock's jacket? I see you two know each other.
Don't be ridiculous. I've never seen this woman before in my life.
Champagne!
My lips belong to the Lord.
Please, make yourself comfortable in the lounge.
Oh, before I go, for your hospitality. And there's a couple of Benjamins underneath the cardinals for you, butler.
How sticky.
I expect to be treated like the wife of a...
Hold that thought. I'll be with you in a moment. This way, please.
Oh, my. What a magnificent mansion. Would you look at the detail on the moldings? Oh,
suppose this letter has me rather anxious.
You must be Mr. Green.
That's exactly who I am.
Welcome, sir.
Wow, this isn't at all what I expected.
I find if you expect nothing, you're never disappointed.
No, I'm not disappointed.
Pardon me, sir. Good evening. Please arrive at 7:30 sharp on Saturday evening. Well, here I am, Professor Plum, if you say so.
Well, and I thought I'd seen everything.
Miss Scarlet, I didn't realize you and the professor were acquainted.
We're not. The bridge is washed up from the rain and my car broke down. This professor over here offered to give me a ride.
And I'm hoping to return the favor one day.
I didn't realize we were headed to the same place until, well, we arrived.
How was your drive? It was a long haul, indeed. It is a long haul. But then, it's a very large house. This way, please.
Say, what is this godforsaken place anyway?
This old place? Oh, this is Body Manor. So, dinner!
Directly!
Appetizers in the lounge. After you. Hors d'oeuvres! I'm starving.
Funny, I haven't much of an appetite at all.
My, this really is a party.
Greetings to you all. It's a pleasure for you all to meet me. Oh, cocktail hour.
There are so many of you.
Right, good then. You're all here. Colonel Mustard.
Present.
Miss Scarlet.
Mm-hmm.
Professor Plum.
Right.
Mr. Green.
Yes, me.
Mrs. White.
Yes.
Mrs. Peacock.
How do you do?
Greetings. I am Wadsworth, the butler. Tonight, as you may have surmised, nobody is being addressed by their real name. A courtesy provided by your host to ensure your privacy. I suggest you all follow in his example and refrain from revealing too much about yourselves. You never know when someone...
Sorry. I'm afraid we're a bit clumsy. Sorry.
Dinner? More like a cocktail minute.
Mr. Wadsworth, we were saying, you never know when. What?
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 Huh?
Huh?
This way, please. We really often keep awaiting. Who can get cranky? Ladies and gentlemen, follow me. The dining room is right this way. Next to your places. Please, be seated.
This place at the head of the table, is this for you?
Indeed, no, sir. I don't sit. I am merely a humble butler.
What exactly do you do?
I butle, sir. Die? Merely quoting, sir, from Alfred, Lord Tennyson.
Well, I prefer Kipling myself. Do you like Kipling, Colonel?
Sure, I'll eat anything. So, who is our host? Is this where he sits?
All in good times, sir.
That smell is something familiar. Shucks been soup, but different.
I know.
Bon appetit! Oh my!
wife of a... Oh yes, I forgot. We're not supposed to say who we really are. But I mean, I have nothing to hide, and I'm so intrigued that this soup is delicious, isn't it?
I know who you are.
You do?
I work in Washington.
Washington? So you must be a politician's wife, speak up.
Yes, I am.
Well, what's his name? Maybe I know him.
He's Mrs. White. You've been awfully quiet. What does your husband do?
Nothing.
Nothing?
Well, he just lies on his back all day.
How lazy.
Not necessarily.
I better not say. I like to follow the rules.
Well, if I was the only one keeping the conversation going, then we would just be sitting here in embarrassed silence.
Are you afraid of silence, Miss Peacock?
Yes? No? Why?
In my professional opinion, it seems like you suffer from what we like to call pressure of speech. Is that an official diagnosis?
Are you a doctor, professor?
In psychological medicine? Not anymore. I do research for you-know-who.
Who?
A branch of the United Nations organization. The World Health Organization.
Oh, you-know-who. It's an acronym.
Oh, I have a sister who is a gymnast. You are a real colonel, aren't you? I am, sir.
Well. Aren't you gonna mention the coincidence that you also live in Washington, D.C., Colonel?
And how did you know that?
Well, I've seen you around.
Does that mean that you live in Washington too, Miss Scarlett?
I sure do. Does anyone here not live in Washington?
This must be about the Red Scare!
I'm a communist! I'm a Republican.
Wadsworth, we've had just about enough of this. Where is our host and why have you been brought here? Between the door and the glass allows sound waves to travel from one side to the other. All the guests have arrived as expected, sir. Everything's going according to plan. We'll meet you in the study.
Study? I don't know the studies. You sure?
Oh, dessert?
No!
In that case, may I suggest we adjourn to the study, at which point I believe our newly arrived host will reveal his intentions. Your letters will be explained, and the game will be afoot. Letter. It will be to your advantage to be present on this date.
because a Mr. Body will bring to end a certain long-standing, confidential, and painful financial liability. As it turns out, you all have one thing in common.
That tyrant McCarthy! We're all being blacklisted, aren't we?
Close, Colonel! You're all being blackmailed. For some considerable time, all of you have been paying more than you can afford to someone who threatens to expose you.
What's someone going to blackmail me for?
I go to church every Sunday.
Yeah, lady. Don't we all?
Anybody else wish to deny it? Until you received your letters, you hadn't known who was blackmailing you. But now I'm certain that even the least discerning amongst you has determined that the man behind your ransom is Mr. Body himself.
Who is this Body fella, your brutish butler?
Who, Mr. Body, is this no concern of yours? Suffice it to say, he is a supporter of the House Un-American Activities Committee, and he feels your activities have been decidedly un-American. My task this evening is to expose your secrets to each other, rendering you all culpable in each other's indiscretions.
But we hardly even know each other.
Precisely.
Don't you think you can spare us this humiliation?
I'm afraid I have no choice. We'll start with you, Professor Plum.
This ought to be good.
It says here, you were once a professor of psychiatry, specializing in pathological, lying lunatics, suffering from delusions of grandeur.
Yes, but now I work for the US government.
So your work has not changed. But you can't practice medicine anymore, can you? Your license has been lifted, correct?
Why? What did he do?
You know what male doctors aren't supposed to do with their lady patients.
Yeah?
Yeah, well, you did.
How awful. You know, someday there'll be a reckoning for men like you.
I hope so.
Me too.
You're disgusting.
Are you making moral judgments, Mrs. Peacock?
Well, I...
How then do you justify taking bribes in return for delivering Senator Peacock's votes to certain lobbyists?
My husband is a paid consultant. There's nothing sinful about that.
Not if it's publicly declared. But if you slip cash under the stall door at Old Ebbets Grill, how would you describe that transaction?
Well, I'd say it stinks.
When were you in that men's room?
So it's true.
No, it's a vicious lie.
But you've been paying the blackmailer for over a year now to keep that story out of the papers. Seems a little sticky, no?
Now see here.
Well, I believe you. I too am being blackmailed for something I didn't do.
So am I.
Not me.
You're not being blackmailed.
Oh, I'm being blackmailed, all right. But I did what I'm being blackmailed for.
What did you do?
Well, I run my own business.
That's not a crime.
Well, you didn't ask what kind of business I run. Okay.
What kind of business do you run?
Well, I provide gentlemen with the company of a young lady.
An escort service? Yeah. In Washington? How scurrilous!
Now, I'm sure some people are just a little lonely. A man who has to spend his money to spend time with a woman is a problem I'll never have.
Is that how you knew Colonel Mustard works in Washington, too? Is he one of your clients?
Certainly not.
I was asking Miss Scarlet.
So you tell him it's not true.
Well, it isn't true.
Is that true?
No, it's not true.
So it is true.
A double negative!
Double negative? So you mean you have photographs?
That sounds like a confession to me. In fact, the double negative itself has led you proof positive. I'm afraid you gave yourself away.
Are you trying to make me look stupid in front of the other guests?
You don't need any help from me, Colonel!
That's right!
Colonel, looks like you hold a sensitive security post in the Pentagon. Those negatives will most certainly compromise your position.
And exactly what position were you guarding, Colonel?
Ha! Is an outbreak. Let's see. Who's next? Mrs. White! You've been a
take our friend the blackmailer ever since your husband died under, shall we say, mysterious circumstances.
Say what you want, but I didn't kill him.
Then why are you paying the blackmailer?
I don't want another scandal now, do I?
Another?
We had a very humiliating confrontation. He had threatened to kill me in public.
Well, why would he threaten to kill you in public?
I think she meant that he had threatened in public to kill her.
It was all over the papers.
And yet, he was the one who died. Not you, Mrs. White, not you.
He was found dead at home. Unclothed, his head had been cut off, and so had his, you know. But I didn't do it. I was out all evening at the movies.
What was showing?
The Naked Alibi.
A likely story.
But he was your second husband. Your first also disappeared.
That was his job. He was an illusionist.
But he never reappeared.
He wasn't a very good illusionist.
And lastly, Miss Degree. Who is that?
I don't need you to unmask me, Wadsworth. I know what you're going to say, though.
What's that?
Mr. Green, who is a homosexual.
Oh, not me!
I beg your pardon.
You asked who is a homosexual, and I said, not me.
Yes, thank you, Colonel. But that's not all, is it, Mr. Green?
What do you mean?
There is evidence to support the question of your politics.
My politics? Since when is working for the Republican Party a crime?
Oh God, Republican!
You swore an oath of allegiance to the Republican Party, but neglected to vote for Eisenhower in the last election. Oh. That grounds for an ousting if ever there was one.
But voting records are confidential.
Everything has its price, Mr. Green.
So, there you have it.
Have what?
A crooked senator's wife, a lascivious doctor, a disloyal Republican, and so forth. Not exactly adhering to an all-American standard of behavior, are you?
Well, it depends on who you ask.
But if this body fellow is such a noble civilian himself, why don't you just report it to the authorities?
And give up the opportunity to make a buck? Come now, Professor. What could be more American than that?
Apple pie!
All right, so we're being blackmailed by a renegade McCaucus. Where does that leave us?
And where is this Mr. Bonnie?
And what does he want with us?
I don't care! I've done nothing wrong. I'm leaving.
I'm sorry, Mrs. Peacock. You can stay in denial, but you cannot leave this house.
Something you could do for me that would change the game.
something I just can't bear to do myself.
What?
Have a seat, please.
What if I don't want to?
Exactly.
It's not right if I sit here.
No.
Sorry.
What's all this about, sir? In this bag, there are 6 packages that I thought our guests might find useful this evening. Packages, presents, if you will. I'm a generous sort of fellow.
Are you?
Wadsworth, will you please see to it that each guest receives a gift?
Gladly.
How kind of you.
Thank you so much.
Oh, thank you. Anyone want to take a guess as to what's in your boxes?
Perfume.
Candy.
A rare single malt Scotch whiskey.
Our guessing game is fun. Please, open.
Candlestick. What's this for?
A wrench.
To the test.
You are?
Mr. Wadsworth here is the only other person who knows of your secrets, and it's costing us all so dearly to keep them quiet.
What do you mean?
I wouldn't have to double your payments if I didn't have to pay Mr. Wadsworth for his silence.
Wadsworth?
That's a lie!
He may look suave and charming, thank you, but really, he's conniving and manipulative.
False!
Why do you think he's called the police?
You called the police?
Only because he instructed me to do so. Did I? Ladies and gentlemen, if you can manage to get rid of Mr. Wadsworth here, I'll have no need to increase your blackmail or expose you to the police.
Get rid of?
Do you think he means kill him?
In fact, if you can eliminate Wadsworth.
Yes, I think that's what he means.
Who not only knows all of your secrets, but also mine. Then I can eliminate your blackmail altogether and be done with this terrible business once and for all.
You would never!
But why not just do it, buddy? Why don't you just do your dirty work yourself?
Yeah!
Why should I, when the 6 of you are so uniquely motivated and armed?
What a patriot!
After all I've done for you!
He's a liar.
I'm one of you! I'm not a butler! I'm a... indented servant. A familiar refrain. Don't make a scene, Wadsworth. It's over. Now's your chance. The only way for you to end your blackmail and avoid finding yourselves on the front pages is for one of you to kill Wadsworth now.
He's dead!
Who had the gun?
I did.
You shot him!
I didn't!
Well, if you did, then I'm dead!
Someone grabbed the gun in my head, and suddenly there was a shot!
There's no gunshot wound!
Oh, God! He's right! There isn't!
Look! There's a bullet mark there!
Eagle eye, Miss Scarlet.
Thank you!
Because the bullet hit the mantle over there, how'd he die right here?
I don't know, I'm not a forensics expert.
Well, something else must have killed him. One of us must have killed him.
Don't look at me. Lie to
you. I need to
screaming!
Some more!
I
Yvette?
Lee!
Yvette, are you alright?
No.
Yvette, are you alive?
Of course I'm alive, you idiot!
Oh!
No thanks to you, Martha! You've locked us up in this house with a Martha!
So the killer is here with us?
Lee!
Where?
Here! We're all looking at him! Oh, ha!
What took you so long?
I'm an old woman who may have been out of it poisoned. It's a miracle I'm anywhere. I heard you all in see Stoughton. One of you is the killer.
How could you hear us in Stoughton?
I was listening. I have a tape recorded in the bedroom connected to the study. Monsieur Barry asked me to record your conversations.
Oh. Why would he make you do that?
For more evidence, of course. Walter reviewed all your figures in the study. Now they are all recorded.
What a snake! I need those tapes! I've got to destroy them!
Get her!
Who cares about the tapes? What about the body?
What body?
Body's body!
But you bet! Why are you swimming in there all by yourself?
Because I was frightened! I also drank the cognac! Maybe I am poisoned too! Plus, one of you is the killer! Monsieur Bobby is dead!
We have to figure out which one of them did it.
What do you mean, which one of them?
Well, I didn't do it.
Well, one of you did! I would have killed him myself, but I didn't have access to a weapon.
Don't look at me!
Well, I thought of a candlestick, geniuses.
Maybe it wasn't one of us.
Who else could it have been?
Who else was in the house?
Only the cook!
The cook!
The cook is not here.
What a lovely kitchen! My husband and I had a kitchen similar to this in our first brownstone. It is such a homey feel, doesn't it?
What?
Dead.
He was!
You should have made sure, Doctor.
guilty.
Maybe he was dead, but someone moved him.
Well, who would move him? And why?
How should I know?
Well, if he's not here, where is he?
Oh my! All this excitement! If you'll excuse me, is there a little girl's room?
Will we window?
No, I just have to powder my nose.
So the toilet's outside the video room.
Thank you.
I don't mean to alarm anybody, but we do currently have the issue of two dead bodies. One missing and one present, and the imminent arrival of the police.
Well, the bridge washed out. That should buy us some extra time.
I don't want extra time. I want the police to arrive. I am trapped in this house with a monster.
Well, once the police arrive, the rest of us are doomed.
Yeah. Wadsworth, am I right in thinking that there is nobody else in this house?
No.
So there is someone else in this house?
Oh, sorry. I said no meaning yes.
No meaning yes.
Yes.
Look, I want a straight answer.
Don't look at me.
You.
Wadsworth, is there someone else in this house, yes or no?
No.
No, there is, or no, there isn't?
Yes.
Okay, there seems to be some confusion about whether or not we are the only people in this house.
There isn't.
There isn't any confusion, or there isn't anybody else.
Either. Both.
Just give me a clear answer.
What was the question?
Is there anyone else in this house?
No!
He says, but does no?
Look! We've got a killer on the loose, the missing body of Mr. Body, the cook with a dagger in her back, and all these easily accessible weapons! The rope, the revolver, the candlestick, the wrench, and... Hey, where's the light pipe?
I believe in, second chances.
Mr. Body dead! Again?
I'm going to faint!
Sorry.
No! This is me, Mom! Get up, woman, yes!
Where all of this happened?
In the bathroom! I opened the door, and there he was! At first, I thought he was attacking me! Then I realized he was left, propped up against the doorframe, dead, just waiting to fall on someone. Who would do such a thing?
It takes a lot of guts to kill someone twice.
That's what we call overkill.
But why? What's the difference?
Well, it makes a difference to him. It
makes a difference to us. We've got to find out who killed him, where, and with what.
Seems like it was probably the lead pipe.
10 points, Professor Plum.
What kind of game are you playing, Wadsworth?
This isn't a game!
You! The lead pipe belonged to you!
But I dropped it when we ran to the kitchen.
People don't just drop murder weapons.
I didn't know it was a murder weapon when I dropped it.
So anyone could have picked it up?
Yes, of course! But who did? Who did pick up the murder weapon? Who picked up the lead pipe and brutally tied up Mr. Body, leaving him dead and bloodied in the bathroom? Who did that? Who? Who? Who?
Call it, Papa! While you're over here losing your marbles, I'm trying to do something useful. Have you all forgotten the evidence against us?
The evidence!
Open it!
Come on.
Body's briefcase is locked.
Oh my God, there must be a key!
Mr. Green, what? Would you be so kind as to search Mr. Body's pockets for the key to his briefcase, containing the evidence of our crimes, so that we may destroy said briefcase once and for all?
Why me?
Why not?
All right.
Where'd you get that?
I really don't like germs.
Uh-huh. Well, fingerprints.
No, honey, it's just germs.
Oh, God.
Here I go. It's all warm. I got it.
We'll give it here.
I'm gonna open it.
What? It's empty.
Oh, empty?
Then where is all the evidence?
I told you Buddy was a liar. Had the evidence in his briefcase by foot.
We must find the evidence.
And destroy it.
Evidence against us aside, we're trapped in a room with two dead bodies.
And she's all the way.
I know. Let's move the corpses to the couch so they look less dead.
Yes. Yeah. Help me, Monsieur.
Okay. We gotta do that.
Deborah, don't get got to the ground.
So, party, this is turning out to be.
So, the
heavier
than they seem.
Never been left behind. I wouldn't know.
Oh,
God.
Oh, God. What should we do?
You're doing great, sweeties. Come on.
And one, two, three. Four.
Yeah, you did that.
There we go. Now
that's all by you.
Up the daisy. Yes.
I'm so strong and virile.
Good. They just look asleep.
Forget about the point. We need to do something about this room full of murder weapons and the homicidal maniac on the loose.
I know. We'll put the weapons in the bag!
What will that do?
Then, we'll zip up the bag!
Most murderers know how zippers work, Mr. Wadsworth!
I know that!
Oh.
We'll put the bag in the safe!
Terrific! Where's the safe?
In the hall!
Use your phone?
Are you a killer?
Oh,
please.
What? No.
All right then, please come in right this way.
Thank you. Where is it?
What, the body?
The phone. What body?
What? There's no body. There's no bitch.
Right, it's my mistake. There's no one in the study.
Oh, no. It's disconnected. And I think there's one in the lounge.
Yes! Alrighty then.
Right through that door.
Thank you so much.
Now listen, we haven't much time. Our task is twofold. One, find the evidence. Two, find the murderer.
We've got one potential suspect. entertained in the lounge. But is this whole restless place up for grabs? Who knows what's on all these doors?
I suggest that we handle this in a proper military fashion. We'll split up and search the house.
Split up?
Yes, I'll split us up into pairs. That way no one will be alone.
But whichever one of us is paired with the killer might get killed.
Oh, and then we'll have discovered who the killer is.
But then the other half of the pair would be dead.
This is war, Peacock. Casualties are inevitable. You cannot make an omelet without cracking eggs. Every cook will tell you that.
Look at what happens to the cook.
Colonel, are you willing to take that chance?
What choice do we have?
Not.
I guess you're right.
All right, troops, divide and conquer. I'll split us up into pairs. Eeny, meeny, miny.
No. Mrs. White, you come with me. Professor Flopgood, Mrs. Peacock. Sebastian, you, Mr. Green, and Miss Scarlet, you're with eeny, meeny.
What if someone doesn't come back?
We'll remember you fondly. Now, leave no door unopened and cherish your partner. This may be the last person you ever see.
We're supposed to look for the evidence.
It's a fruitless search, if you ask me. I mean, it's not like we're just gonna walk into a room and find evidence plastered on the wall.
I suppose you're right.
Maybe we can go upstairs. There might be something exciting in the bedroom.
I haven't been excited by something in a bedroom for years.
I have the key!
haven't. It's gone!
Gone!
Not to beat a dead horse, but again, I feel like having all the keys is really impossible.
I thought you said you didn't know where your key was!
I did say that! But I didn't do that. We got distracted by the motors, the door, and I forgot. One of you must have snatched the keys from my pockets when we were searching the house.
So whichever one of us has the keys is the killer.
Precisely.
Well, speaking of the killer, there's a dead body in the lounge, you know, of a motorist is dead.
So which one of you killed him?
We found him. Together.
And he was already dead,
but the door to the lounge was locked.
We went through a secret passage we found at the conservatory.
A secret passage? Who designed this place?
The Parker brothers.
Anonymous tip about an abandoned car by the gates of this mansion. Did a motorist stop by for help by any chance?
No!
So there seems to be some disagreement. At any rate, can I come in and use the phone?
No!
Of course you may, officer. There's a phone right there in the study.
Out of order.
Funny mistake. There's a phone in the lounge.
Out of order. If you please, you may use the phone in the library.
Yes!
This way, please.
You all are acting rather peculiar.
It's because that chandelier fell down. It's good that killed us, but don't worry, the maid will clean it up.
That's all well and good, but what's going on in the lounge in the study?
Lounging, studying. This way, please.
Let me have a look.
No, thank you.
What?
This way, please. Officer, let me take what is right to a body manner. This house was built by Lord Reginald Bonney in 1789.
We've got to cover our tracks and get rid of this.
Lord Bonney declared Lord Bonney after somebody discovered antibodies that would save everybody. Notice the mahogany floors. Crafted specifically for Lord Bonney. Did you know? In the 17th century, the buccaneer John Esquelman recorded the first use of mahogany for canoes. Can you canoe?
What? Wait, where'd everyone go?
No, this is the cast iron door knobs. Crafted specifically for Lord Bonney by his buddy in Saturday.
I don't care about the doorknobs, mister. What's going on in those two rooms?
Which two rooms?
The lounge and the study!
Oh, yes. Those two rooms.
Yes!
No, officer, I don't think you should go in there.
Why not?
Because it's all too shocking.
Oh, hello, officer. Welcome to the party.
Oh, excuse me.
You are excused.
Pardon me.
Good night, officer.
Good night. That wasn't all too weird. Those were just some, you know, folks having a good time. Why didn't you tell me this was a party?
My apologies,
If you don't mind, I'll just take a look in here.
Oh!
Hey!
Hey, officer.
Hey! Are those men drunk?
Get drunk!
Oh. No, thank you. The chief would kill me if I drank on the job. What was that? Have a lovely evening, officer. You too.
Officer, officer, I can explain
everything. No need. There's nothing illegal about any of this.
There isn't.
Of course. This is America. And that was the pursuit of happiness. Could I use the phone now?
Of course, officer. This way, please. The lottery officer.
Thank you.
Now listen. All done very well. You can come out now. Now listen. I've locked you in the lounge.
How did you do that? I thought you didn't have the keys.
I don't have my right pocket keys, but my left pocket keys are very much intact. Now, we must finish searching the manor. The police are on their way.
The police have already arrived.
Not the broken down car police. The criminal investigation police.
Precisely. Now, we can't afford any more murders. This is getting dangerous. Now, go!
Hello? The power went out? Must be the storm. Hi, Chief. Yeah, this is... Hello? Hello? Are you still there? Is this thing working?
Hello? Oh, don't have the lights. Hello? Oh, it's only you. I thought you was a killer.
Hello? Hello? Did somebody cut the line?
Is that a clue? What is that in your hand?
I found this abandoned car by this old mansion where all the lights just went out. Listen, I'm telling you, there's something funny going on around here. They're having some sort of party and you won't believe what I saw.
Huh?
No!
And now we're singing Telegram Girl!
But who is the killer?
What? Ain't that the million-dollar question?
Sometimes the most obvious answers are right under our noses. I think the best possible option is to retrace our steps. It all started like this. At the start of the evening, there was thunder, lightning, and a dog's bark. Ding dong, Colonel Buster. Ding dong, Mrs. White, who noticed the event. Then, Mrs. Peacock, who noticed a cock. Then, Mr. Green, sit. No, no, not you, sir. Please come in. Then, Professor Plum, Miss Scarlet. Then, dinner is served. Then, well, that was more like a cocktail minute. To the dining room. Stoughton soup. Oh, yummy, yum, my favorite. Then the body arrived, and we all went to the study. Coffee, brandy. Who is this, Mr. Body Butler? How do you do? Then Mr. Body asked me to pass out packages. Ah, a snake. Oh no, it's a rogue. Then Mr. Body turned out the lights. Now.
But
if we are alive.
Superman alert!
Well done, Wadsworth.
That's what I said.
Yes, well, I'm saying now, I'm Hank Cuff, Chief of Police. Professor Plum, you're coming with me.
That's not how it happened. It happened like this.
All right, we're listening, Professor Plum. Who do you choose?
It was Colonel Mustard. In the lounge with the wrench.
I never lounge.
I found your Medal of Honor in the lounge where the motorist was killed. But it's the wrench. The wrench that belonged to you.
That's a lie.
The wrench is missing. Gentlemen, turn out your pockets. Ladies, empty your purses. Whoever has the wrench is the killer.
Aha! Well done, Wadsworth.
Not the kernel of truth in him.
Well done, Wadsworth.
That's what I said.
Yes, well, I'm saying it now. Guilty verdict, Chief of Police. And Colonel Mustard, you're coming with me.
You got it all wrong. It happened like this.
All right then, we're listening, Colonel. Who do you choose?
It was Mrs. White! In the billiard room, with the rope.
I would rather die!
I found your veil in the billiard room. And I saw how you cringed at Yvette's when she served you dinner.
Yes, I knew Yvette. She had a torrid love affair with my late husband. I hated him. I hated her so much that the flames! Flames on the side of my face! Breathing! Rats! But just because I hated her, it doesn't mean I killed her!
The rope is missing! Gentlemen, turn out your pockets! Leave!
Well done, Wadsworth!
Well done, Wadsworth!
That's what I said!
Yes, well, I'm saying it now. Mark my words, Chief of Police. Mrs. White.
It happened like this!
Retracing our steps?
It's all part of the game!
Game!
Yeah, I'm the last, now you see. Now that you've killed everyone off, there's no evidence left against me. I've got up, scot free.
But the police will be here any minute!
Huh?
What's so funny?
Nobody's called the police, have they?
They were never on their way!
Now this is empty, Reverend! We are gonna sack the bodies in the cellar. Lock the cellar door. Leave Body Man one at a time and gut that any of this ever happened.
But I can't forget all of this.
With Moya on the menu, the price of blackmail just tripled.
Forgotten!
Now go!
Wait a minute! We can all rush him! He's got no more bullets left in the gun!
Don't think we're gonna fall for that old trick!
It's not a trick! There was one shot in Mr. Body, two at the chandelier, two at the lounge door, and one at the singing telegram girl.
That's not six!
That's 1 + 2 + 2 + 1, actually.
Nah! There was only one shot at the chandelier! So that's 1 + 2 + 1 + 1!
Even if you were right, which you're not, that would be 1 + 1 + 2 + 1, not 1 + 2 + 1 + 1. Do you get it?
Alright, 1 + 1. Yeah, shut up! Point is, there is one bullet left in this gun. And anybody who moves is gonna get it.
So you're just gonna keep blackmailing us? Are we supposed to forget this all happened?
Of course. Why not?
I'll tell you why not.
Larry Hammond!
Oh,
FBI! The Jake is up. Or is it?
Miss King,
you're FBI?
Apparently, I'm a dead ringer for Green. He received a letter just like each of you. But he came to the Bureau to ask for help. I took his place tonight so we can have a sting operation.
Stop the sting! 6 people died on your watch!
I usually work the desk. Might be his property crime, you know, theft, fraud. That's why I was so tickled when the real boss risked his neck to drop an entire briefcase full of evidence off last night.
You have had the evidence this entire time?
All year. Miss Scarlett's books, including client names and dates of service, proving she's one of DC's top madams, just to find why she killed a cop who listed here on her payroll.
Give it here.
Ooh, and what's this? A love letter addressed to Professor Plum.
That's private property.
That singing telegram girl was the underage daughter of the head of the you-know-who. Who would have come clean to daddy? Who would have cleared you out, Professor Plum? So you shut the get back in here. And these negatives. And these negatives. And these negatives, Colonel. Quite the regular Miss Scarlet's establishment. Bet you couldn't be a colonel anymore if that motorist had informed your general of where he drives you on Tuesday nights.
I just wanted someone to talk with.
Sharkfin soup indeed, Mrs. Peacock. Too bad your cooks couldn't keep quiet. If only she had blabbed about your bribes, maybe you wouldn't have killed her just before joining us outside the billiard room. Now we know what really took you so long.
Circumstantial evidence will never hold up in court.
Yeah, but now you really did hate it. Here's a vial containing fingerprints collected at the seams of your previous murders.
I never murdered my husband.
Fingerprints, I'm sure the FBI will be able to match with those found on the noose tied around the event's neck.
I used gloves.
You mean these?
Damn it!
And last but not least, Mr. Body Body.
It's Robert!
Now you didn't hate him at all, did you now, Mr. Body?
What's it to you?
illicit green card love affair is the icing on the cake for this FBI file. A file on the whole Body family. Your butler, the real Wadsworth, has been feeding us information for months. Talk about a real American.
He was British!
You know what I mean. Your shot missed him in the study, but he wisely claimed death. It wasn't until you caught him trying to escape that you bludgeoned him to death with the lead pipe that I dropped on my way to the kitchen.
I mean, really? Who just drops murder weapons?
I didn't know it was a murder weapon. Anyways, the Bai family has been wanted for organized crime for generations, but they've always eluded the law. Until now, tonight, this body business has come to a dead end.
You leave my family out of this! Ow! Ow! Ah! Larry. Hold me, Larry.
You do it, please. Oh.
It's so dark. Take a wind!
No!
If I knew you were coming, I'd take a day. Ow! 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 Ow!
I'm gone.
He's dead.
No.
Not yet.
Come on.
Smile when your heart is breaking. Smile even though it's aching. When there are clouds in the sky,
you'll get by.
That's the time you must keep on trying.
Smile, what's the use in crying?
You will find that life is still worth
enough.
While if you just help me smile.
Oh,
Mama.
No.
Oh, Larry. Oh, Larry. In all the world, you have walk in line. Now. Get off me!
I tell you, this is the most exciting night I've had in a long time. Anyways, you're all under arrest! Tape recordings of the confessions in the billiard room.
Thanks!
All right, who done it?
He did
it! Hell did it! If you want to know who killed Mr. Body, it was me, Special Agent Larry Goodman, in the hall with my gun.
Well done, Goodman.
That's what he said!
And that's how it really happened! Ah! Sorry. Okay, Chief, take him away. I'm gonna go home and sleep with my wife.